Hey guys, it's Adi here, and today we have an unboxing of the Nokia XL, which is the largest member of the Nokia X family, which is Nokia's Android devices. So let's take a look at it. So the Nokia XL is one of the Nokia X family, which is Nokia's brand of Android phones. And basically, it's the third family member between the X Plus, the X, and the XL, and it's the largest screen device of them, and it has the highest specs of them all. Right away, one thing you'll notice is the fact that the box no longer follows the classic Nokia blue, which you've had for so many other devices, such as the Lumia 1520, or just any basically Lumia device or any Nokia device that's been launched in the past 3 years, whether it's the Nokia 808 or the Lumias or the N9 even. However, these devices come on a white background with very colorful devices on the front. And this is actually due to some of the changes, I guess, with the recent Microsoft acquisition of the Devices Services division, where the new boxes are the new look. So you'll find the same design of the box with the white backdrop with the colorful devices on up new Lumias, such as the Lumia 630 and 930 once that's released as well. So just an interesting fact that you have the all-new box design as well. So a tour of the box. On the front, we have the Nokia X Plus showing, the side, the Nokia X Plus as well. The back, nothing. The side, just the name, Nokia X Plus Dual SIM. And on the back, we also have some of the specs and what's available in the box. You can see the available colors are green, orange, yellow, black, white, and cyan. Inside the box comes the phone, the battery, the startup guide, a charger, and headphones. And for your details, it's the fast lane to Android apps. So Nokia are very adamantly saying that it's not really Android, it's just a way to get Android apps. And they're even calling the OS Nokia X Platform version 1.0, but is actually based on Android open source projects, so it can run Android apps, but it does not have the Google apps integrated in it. The specs of the device on the phone is a 5-inch WVGA LCD, which is 480p, which means the PPI of the device is around 187 PPI, which is pretty okay for a mid-range device or a low-end device, even if you're gonna call it. 2-megapixel front-facing camera and a 5-megapixel rear camera, and a Qualcomm Snapdragon 1 gigahertz dual-core processor. So, shall we check out the box and what's inside it? So, as usual, the box has a little color tab behind it to indicate what color your device is, and this is a black one. So, if we slide it out, we will see the black Nokia XL. It's quite large, but I'm used to my Lumia 1520 now, so shouldn't be an issue for me. Oops. So we'll put that aside and in frame and continue looking at what else is in the box. We also have the quick start guide in Arabic. And below the flap, we have the charger, which is a standard micro USB charger, such so you can use any other charger you have around, no worries. We also have the headphones, which are some standard, normal headphones. And the battery. We have the battery, which is the BNO2, a 2000 milliamp battery designed for Nokia. So 2000 milliamps is pretty sweet. I mean, you can get a lot of work out of a 2000 milliamp battery, especially on a 5-inch device such as this. So it's a very large battery, and hopefully the battery performance is nice. So let's take a look at the device itself and run through it. So up front, we have the 5-inch 480p screen. WVGA. We also have the 2-megapixel front-facing camera, which you can see up there. You also have the light sensor over here. So, and on the bottom we have a single capacitive touch button, which is the back button. It is not a physical depression, it is just simple touch. On the right-hand side of the device, you have a layout similar to the Lumia devices, where you have the volume key and you have the power button. On the back of the device, we have the speaker jack, and you have the 5-megapixel camera and the LED flash. And you can also see that it has SIM 1, which can be 3G or 2G, and the second optional SIM, which can only support 2G. On the left-hand side of the device, you have absolutely nothing. And up top, we have the 3.5 mm headphone jack. And on the bottom, you have the micro USB charging port. So that's pretty much it for the walk around of the device. Be sure to stay tuned for our full video coverage and thoughts on the Nokia X Plus and the Nokia X Platform in general. And what do you guys think of the color? I think the black one looks really classy. I mean, I was honestly looking for an orange, but I couldn't find it. And the black actually looks really nice, and it has a nice solid feel to it. The corners are a bit square, like very sharp, not sharp, I'd say well-defined corners that make it nice to hold in the hand. And given the fact that I've been used to the Lumia 1520, it feels absolutely comfortable in the palm of my hand, although not everyone would agree. So that's pretty much it for our unboxing of the Nokia XL. Leave your comments on the video down below. What are your thoughts on the phone? What are your thoughts on the Nokia X platform in general? And while we're at it, what do you think of the new Nokia box design? I mean, I know a lot of people like the Nokia Blue, so what are your thoughts on this new, I guess we can call it Microsoft White? So that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys around in the next video.